Everybody, today I'm going to be doing a tutorial of the translation app in MIT App Inventor. And before we get started with the tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate what the app looks like and how it works. So here's the app pulled up on my screen. And as you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 buttons and 1, 2 text box. So the first button says Speak English. And if you click on this button, it's going to pull up a speech recognizer where you can say anything you want. It'll recognize what you say, and it's going to put that into this text box. Then when you click the Translate to Spanish button, it'll take that text in this text box and translate it to Spanish into this text box. And then once you click the Speak Spanish button, the device is going to speak in Spanish what was in this text box. And when you click Clear, it's going to clear both of these two text boxes. So let me just do an example for you. Hello, how are you? As you can see, it took what I said and put it into this first text box. Then if I hit Translate to Spanish, it's going to translate that text into the second text box. And then if I click Speak Spanish,
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
It just said what was in this text box. And now if I click Clear, it's just going to erase both text box. So that is the app that we're going to build today. So to get started with building the app, we want to make sure we're in the Create App section of MIT App Inventor, which should look like what I have on the screen. First, we want to make sure that we're using the correct user interface. And to do so, we're going to click Settings up here, User Interface Settings. Make sure that Neo is selected, and then press OK. Now we're going to create a new project using this button, and we're just going to name it Translation App. Just like that, and click OK. It should bring you to this screen where we can start building our app. So before we put any components onto our screen, I want to just first change my background color. And to do so, I'm going to click on Screen 1 over here. Under Background Color, you can click this box and choose whatever color you want. You can also choose a custom color and just drag wherever you want your color to be. I'm going to make mine this purple pink color, and I'm going to press Done. And as you can see, it changed the background color of the screen. So now we can start putting components onto our app. So the first component we're going to want is a button. And we're going to go all the way on top under User Interface and drag a button onto the screen. This is going to be the Speak English button, and we want to rename the button. And to do so, we're going to press on the button over here, click on Rename, and we're going to name this Speak English button. And we're going to use the convention we call camel case, which means that there are no spaces in the name, and the first letter of each word is capitalized. So it's going to be Speak with a capital S, no space, then English with a capital E, and then button with a capital B, no space. Just like this. And we're going to press OK. And as you can see, that the button has been renamed. And this is just so that when we have a lot of buttons and a lot of other components, that we can easily identify which is which. And now we're going to change the details of the button. So I'm going to make the background color of this button green, as you can see here. Then I'm going to make the font size of it 24, just so I can see the text better. And then we want to change the text to Speak English. And this is what it looks like. And I'm also going to change the shape of this button to be rounded because that's what I like, but you can also do it rectangular or oval, just depends on what you like. But I like mine rounded. And as you can see, this button is in the upper left-hand side, and I want it to be centered on the screen. And to just fix that, we're going to go over here on the right-hand side, click on Screen 1, then under Align Horizontal, we're going to click Center, and then Align Vertical, we're going to click Center as well. So now we have our first button on the screen. Next, we're going to add a text box And it's also going to be on the left-hand side. Drag this text box under the Speak English button. And then we're going to rename this text box. Also using camel case, we're going to name it Spoken Text Box. Just like that. And then we're going to change the details of it. So I'm going to make the background color of it white. Then I'm going to make the font size 24 as well, so we can see the text bigger. Then we're going to make the width of it to fill parent. And then we're going to select multi-line. So the multi-line will ensure that if you speak a lot of things, that it's not going to run off the screen and that it'll split all that text into multiple lines. So I'm going to drag another button under this text box. And then I'm going to rename this button to Translate Spanish button. And this is the button that we're going to click when we want to translate the text we have into Spanish. And I'm going to make the background color of this button green. I'm going to make the font size 24. I'm going to make the shape of it rounded, and then the text is going to be Translate to Spanish. Just like this. And then once we have clicked this Translate to Spanish button, we're going to need another text box to hold the translated text. So I'm going to drag this under here. I'm going to rename it to the Translated Text Box. Press OK. Then I'm going to change the background color of it to white. I'm going to make the font size 24. I'm going to select multi-line, and the width is going to fill parent, just like that. And now we're going to add a third button under this text box, and we're going to rename this button to Speak Spanish button. And click OK. And then I'm also going to make the background color of this green. The font size I'm going to make 24. I'm going to make it rounded. And then this is going to be Speak Spanish, the text. And so this is what we should have so far. Before I add the last button, the clear button, I'm going to add in what I call a horizontal arrangement, and you can find that in layout, and it'll be the first one, horizontal arrangement. I'm just going to put it under Speak Spanish. And this is to give it some space between buttons, because if you just have two buttons, one after the other, there's going to be no space between them. And with the horizontal arrangement, I'm going to make the height of it 5 pixels. You can make it more or less depending on how much space you want between the buttons, but I think 5 is pretty good. And then for the width, I'm going to fill parent. And it's going to look like this. And then I'm going to add in my last button under that. And then this button I'm going to rename to Clear Button. And press OK. And then since this is a clear button, I'm going to make the background color of it red, because that's going to tell people that if you click this button, everything's going to be erased. And just so that they know, the red pops out and they can recognize that. I'm going to make the font size of it 24. The shape I'm going to make rounded. And then the text I'm going to do clear in all caps. Just like that. So this is all that we will need for the visible components. And then we're going to need some non-visible components, because when we speak English, we want the speech recognizer to pop up. Then we want something to translate the text into Spanish. And then when we click Spanish, we want a text-to-speech. And those components can be found on the left-hand side under Media. So we're going to want the speech recognizer. Make sure it's over the screen. And then it'll pop up down here in non-visible components. Then for the Translate to Spanish button, we need the translator. So we're also going to put that over the screen. And the last one we need is the text-to-speech. And then this is the three non-visible components that we want. For the text-to-speech component, as you can see on the right-hand side, there is some behaviors that we can edit. And so since we're doing this translating to Spanish, we want the country to be Spain, which is going to be ESP. And these are three-letter country codes. And I can just show you right here the different kinds of country codes that we have. So these are all the country codes, and we can see that we used ESP for Spain. But if you do a different language, you can also choose a different country. And then for language, we're going to be using ES, which is for Spanish. And these are called two-letter language codes. As you can see over here, let me pull this up. If we go down to Spanish, we can see that here we have ES is our language two-letter language code for Spanish. And so now we finished with the building part of the app, and now we want to code it. So let's go over two blocks and start the coding. So the first thing that we want to code is when the person hits the Speak English button. So we're going to go over to the Speak English button and drag in this when Speak English button dot click. So when the person clicks the Speak English button, we want to call on the speech recognizer. So we're going to go over to Speech Recognizer 1, and we're going to do call speech recognizer dot get text. And then once the speech recognizer has finished getting that text, which is going to be when speech recognizer 1 dot after getting text, we want to put that text into the spoken text box. So we're going to go over to spoken text box, and we're going to set the spoken text box text, which is over here, to your result. Just hover over this and we can drag in the get result. Perfect. And then so I'm going to go back to the designer and show you what we've coded so far. So we've done when the person clicks the Speak English button, the speech recognizer is going to get that text and then it's going to put it into this box. Next, let's do the Translate to Spanish button. So let's go over to Translate to Spanish button all the way at the top. And when the Translate Spanish button is clicked, we want to call on the translator. Down here, we're going to call translator. And then language to translate to, we're going to go all the way to the top over text and drag in this empty text. And we want to translate from English to Spanish. And to do so, we're going to use our two-letter language codes. So let's go back over to those two-letter language codes and find English. So for English, we're going to have here, it's EN. So we're going to go back to our blocks, and in this, we're going to click EN dash. And then if you remember what the Spanish one was, it's going to be ES. So it'll be EN dash ES. And this just tells the app that we want to translate from English to Spanish. And then the text that we want to translate is going to be in the spoken text box text. So we're going to go over to spoken text box and we're going to get that text. And it's going to be this one here. And just pop it in here. And then once it has gotten that translation, so we're going to click translator. When it's gotten that translation, we want to put that translated text into the translated text box. So let's go to translated text box and set that text right here. Set that text into your translation. So hover over translation and then get translation. And your block should look like what we have on the screen. And so let's go back and see what we've done. So we've done the Speak English and it's going to paste that text into here. Then we've just done the Translate to Spanish, which will translate that text into Spanish and put it into this box. And now let's do the last two buttons. So let's go over to blocks, and then we have our Speak Spanish button. So let's go over to the top, and when the Speak Spanish button is clicked, we want to call the text-to-speech, and it's going to be text-to-speech, and this block that says call text-to-speech. And the message we want to speak is going to be in the translated text box. So we want to go to translated text box, and then get the translated text box text, which will be this block, and just pop it in there. And then for the clear button, I'm going to press that, go to the top, and when the clear button is clicked, we want to clear both the spoken text box and the translated text box. So we're going to go to spoken text box, and we're going to set that text to, and then we're going to go up to text, very top, drag in this clear empty text. And then we're going to do the same thing for the translated text box. So we're going to set the translated text box text to up here, the very top, this empty text string. And this is all that we need for our code. So let's just go back to our designer and make sure we have everything. So we've done the Speak English button, and then we've done the Translate to Spanish button, and we just did the Speak Spanish button that will call on the text-to-speech, and then we did the Clear button that will clear both of these text box. So we've completed our app, great job, and now we can test it out by using our companion device. So you can grab your phone, your iPad, or tablet, and then what you can do is you can connect to your app by going to Connect and clicking AI Companion, and make sure you have the Companion app downloaded on your device, which it should be just MIT AI 2 Companion. And in the device, you can scan your QR code, and it'll be this QR code that you have populated. And so I'm just going to scan it with my device and show you what the app looks like on my end. So here I have pulled up my app, and as you can see, we have your Speak Spanish, Translate to Spanish, or Speak English, Translate to Spanish, and Speak Spanish. So let's click the Speak English button. Hello, how are you? And as you can see, it pasted it into the first text box. When I click Translate to Spanish, it translated it into this text box. And then when I click the Speak Spanish button,
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
It should speak what was in this text box. And then if I hit Clear, it's going to erase everything. So that is our app. I hope you had so much fun building it. You guys did a great job. And if we want to think about some extensions we can make to this app, what about if we don't want to just translate from English to Spanish? What if we want to do from Spanish to English or from English to a different language? How would we modify our app to do that? We can also think about having maybe a list of different languages that the user can translate to from English, so they can just pick from that list. Or if we don't want to limit the user, can we think of a way that we can ask the user what language they want to translate from and to, and then using that, the app will help them do that. Those are just some fun things to think about if you really want to expand your skills and try them out. I would really encourage you to, but thank you for following along with this tutorial, and I hope you had so much fun.